In our previous session, we talked about how to create this image for the slider, how to crop it, how to resize it, how to optimize it for the web, and how to add this banner here across the bottom that draws the end user's eye to click the picture and not the button over here. In this session, we'll learn how to add these pictures to the slideshow, how to set the timing of the slideshow in terms of how long it takes for the pictures to rotate from one to the other, and how to add text to these buttons. So let's begin. Let me quickly point out that this is the CSU Extension state site, and so I'm not going to be using these images and this text on the state website because I don't want the pictures and text to appear and disappear over the course of the day as I'm recording this tutorial. So I'll be using my own website, but I'll be using the pictures and the text from the state website. And here we are at my own website, and this is the slider we'll be working on to add the state website pictures over here on the left and buttons over here on the right. This is my own site, so I have this bar up top, and if I click the name of my site at the very upper left here, I can see dashboard. So I click that, and that takes us to the dashboard of my site, and here is where I can start fine-tuning this site for the public. Your dashboard will look similar to this, though there are options on my dashboard that are not enabled on yours. However, for practical purposes, these are the same. Go to this left side navigation, choose Appearance, and choose Theme Options. From Theme Options, we go to Slider Settings, about a third of the way down on this left-hand navigation panel. And here are the fields. The slider speed is in milliseconds, so 8,000 would be 8 seconds. 3,500 would be 3.5 seconds, and so on. Each slider has four fields to work with: the image, the heading, the description, and the link. So let's begin. We'll start by uploading our image. We'll click Upload Image. We're already in the folder we want to be working with. So we'll double-click the image, and it loads down here. Our next field is first slider heading. So I'll type in Farm to Table, and I'll cut and paste in the description. I will cut and paste in the link for our first slider. We'll go up top here, or rather down bottom here, click Save All Changes. This will take a few seconds, but then you'll see that options are updated, and so you go to Extension Technology Training and choose Visit Site to look at your work, and we can now see that this first button on the slider has the correct image, the correct title, the correct text, and when we click the image, it takes us to the Farm to Table website. So that is how to set up the first slider image. And let's build our second slider image next. I will go to the dashboard. I'll go to Appearance and Theme Options. I'll go to Slider Settings, and we'll move down the second slider image, click Upload Image, and again, here is the folder already where we keep our images, and this is the 4H image we want to use. It is uploaded. I'll cut and replace the second slider heading. I'll cut and replace the second slider description, and then I'll go down. The link for the second slider, I will also Control A to select it all, and Control V to paste in where that link goes. We'll again move to the lower part of the page at the bottom on the right. Click Save All Changes. Options are updated. And now when we go to visit our site, you can see that our first two slider images are working. The text and the title are there, and the link works correctly. You do that for every slider image, so there'll be five of them, and all the fields are pretty much the same: the image, the heading, the description, and the link for each of the five slider images. You don't need to use five, though it probably works best with five. You can work with under five, and then you're done. And that is how to build a slider. We'll visit the site one last time. I'm visiting the CSU state site rather than my own. And here's the slider one last time with all our pictures here, all our titles and texts here, and all of our links working. And that is how to build the slider on your homepage for the CSU Extension WordPress website.